chance there for Barnes. Really was laid a plate by McKinnon. Oh, really quite remarkable, the involvement of Alec Barnes in the last 5 or 10 minutes.
Stein.
The Mullow supporter. Performance and the commitment and effort demonstrated by the team. Denham, that very sweet left foot. No one on the far side though, except Charlie Miller for Rangers. Lambert and Martin together. That's confident play. Eddie May with Dolan Patrick. The free kick goes to Motherwell. Oh, Bunce had that great chance of only 2 ago.
Good ball on McKinnon across the face of the goal, and Burns there really a side for the chance. Couldn't quite get his legs right, couldn't quite get the ball down, couldn't quite make contact with the ball in the first place. A real good chance, Alex Burns could have had 2 goals in the space of about 2 or 3 minutes. Rangers can't get the ball away, they can't get the ball out, they can't hold on to the ball and make a few passes and try and kill the situation, try and calm their nerves at the moment, because Motherwell really are on the ascendancy. Motherwell can't quite finish Rangers off. They've been in some great positions, probably the best positions that they have all game, and not got a goal to show from it. So I think McLeish will be a little bit disappointed they haven't got anything to show from 2 great breaks, in particular from Alex Burns. But they've still got the momentum, they've still got the free kick on the edge of the box, and Alex Burns really proving a bit of a handful for Richard Gough and also for Gordon Pettridge.
Conference going on now in the Rangers dugout. Walter Smith has come down to discuss things with Archie Knox and David Dodds. Bit of eye damage there for Richard Gough. He had a black eye a couple of weeks ago. So the recurrence perhaps of the damage there. But a free kick from Motherwell. The same trio involved again. Lambert, Davis, McKinnon. Andy Gordon all out on the line. McKinnon forced to do that because of Mikhailichenko's charge at the ball. Mikhailichenko again doing well. Here's Gordon Jury, wants to go for a run. Forced the ball past a couple of players, but Davis was there for Motherwell. That's Krivokovic. Krivokovic again picks out the pass carefully for Martin. Here's McSkimming. Davis, McSkimming, Barnes, May. Good tackle by Robertson, but once again Motherwell demonstrating a kind of form which took them to the top of the league last season.
Not difficult to see how Motherwell were in contention for so long last season.
Now they have to defend again as Loudrup breaks. It's a great early ball. Well, Jury took the decision to take that first time. He had the possibility, I think, of bringing it down.
Applauding Brian Loudrup. Great play, good ball inside by Ian Ferguson there. Brian Loudrup looks at the far post. I think Gordon Jury could have come and headed that really instead of trying to sweep it down. Even if he'd have taken a touch, I think Brian Martin would have got to block the shot or whatever, but a header across the face of the goal, probably his trademark, might have resulted in a goal or an opportunity for somebody else, but probably took the wrong option and put the ball over the bar.
The Rangers showing they retain a high degree of menace when they break like that, especially when they get Loudrup involved. Well, a feast of football coming up on Sky Sports. Terrific action over the weekend and into the Christmas break. Super Sunday starting at 11 o'clock, note the time. Leeds United against Manchester United. Here's Gordon Jury, the chance for the opener. Scott Harry goes down, and still Motherwell survive. Well, Eddie May playing a pass there to Brian Martin inside the 6-yard box. Quite incredible. Martin clearing up in the end. Scott Howie did well though that time. Goes Gough. Breaks for Mikhailichenko. Gough attacking the ball again. There's Jury. That's a very good turn by Jury. Looking for a rash tackle inside the box. Back with David Robertson. Gough goes up again. Well held by Howie.
Well, the ball played through to Gordon Jury now. Just a good bit of pace here, good bit of strength holds off Brian Martin, thinks about placing it, tries to go inside Scott Harry, tries to lay the ball, I think, into somebody's path. Scott Harry didn't quite read the dummy, able to get back, and Eddie May passed to Brian Martin, who's able to clear the danger. But good play there, typical endemic really of Motherwell's team spirit. They're clean through their Gordon injury. They managed to get back in numbers, they managed to get back in force, and that's been typical of their performance, a really rugged and solid performance from them.
That's Mikhailichenko back defending. Here's Eddie May. Well, scarcely enough time before the action this match to tell you about the matches coming up. But Blackburn Rovers against Manchester City on Boxing Day, starting at 7:30 in Sky Sports. Then the big one, Manchester United against Newcastle United. 5:30 start for the programme on Wednesday, December 27. And later that evening also, Bolton Wanderers against Leeds United. It really is a beast. Now Denham. Forward goes McKinnon. Burns is going to cross also to give some help to McKinnon. Great left foot he's got. Mikhailichenko. Another excellent left foot. Gordon Dewey takes the break of the ball there. McKinnon wins it back. Well, it's really remarkable, Terry. This game's still goalless.
We've had some great efforts on goal, great saves by the goalkeepers. Woodwork been hit twice, once on by the side of that blocks, headers, everything scrambles in the goal with one-on-ones. We've had a lot, really. We haven't got a goal, and we should have got a goal from either side.
So a foul there by Gordon Petrich on Andy Roddy. And a change going to be made here by Motherwell. Brian Martin, who's been struggling with injury, he has to come off after a terrific performance in the heart of that Motherwell defence. And the replacement going on is Innes Ritchie, a direct replacement, centre-back for centre-back. 22-year-old. He's had some first-team experience this season. It's helped on by Barnes. Goff comes it away. Time for Roddy here to set up a cross. That's big skimming. Thought about taking that on the hook, but turns back. May forward. There's no offside. Back with Denham. Now McSkimming. Well, there were chances there, options all over the place. Over on the far side, Billy Davis was streaming for the ball. Alec McLeish is down there, looking tense.
There's an old dink ball into the box here. Burns really had a lot more space than he thought he had. Probably should have met that first time, Greg Denham, but he didn't. He just laid the ball off there to McSkimming, he put his shot wide. But Greg Denham had that ball been on his left-hand side, he would have been able to smash that one on goal, but as it came straight down to the middle of him, he couldn't decide which foot to strike it with, and consequently passed to McSkimming and put it over the bar. Good chance.
Well, Mikhailichenko in that unaccustomed wing-back position on the right-hand side. Always given cover by Alan McLaren behind him, right enough. There's Laudrup. Forward pace matched by Lambert. That's great play by Laudrup. Cross is too long, though. Robertson retrieves, and there's nowhere to go. Wow, in the closing 10 minutes, Alec McLeish now sensing that Motherwell can win this. Certainly a blow, though, to lose Brian Martin at this stage, Terry.
Yes, he's played very well alongside Kvokopic and Denham. They've formed a very solid barrier against Rangers, and it's a pity because he was in line for the man of the match, so we'll have to wait and see who we decide is the man of the match. But I've got to make an awkward choice now. But you know, at the end of the day, he has played very well. He's been very assured. He's been able to get on the end of good crosses from Rangers, block any chances. He's been able to create attacks as well, and always a danger in the Rangers penalty area. So just a straight one-for-one swap. But Alec McLeish, we saw him there whistling and getting a bit hurried. He must be disappointed in a way that I've had two great chances and not failed to, and failed to score both of them.
McKinnon trying to get the better of Mikhailichenko. He's managed that. That's a very good cross. Chance on this time. Roddy with a header. Gordon with a save. The counter-attack on here. Space in the centre of Derek McInnes. He's brought down by Lambert. Brian McSkimming, rather, I think, made the challenge. McInnes so frustrated there. A captured again for Motherwell, and another player limping off is Billy Davis. So he goes off, and number 12 coming on is Jamie Dolan. That's the first of these electronic score signs there for the substitutes of this country. Motherwell with that Italian invention to demonstrate the change of players. Dennis flights it in, it's headed on by Goff, met well by Denham, resisting the challenge of Ferguson. Ferguson again. He's overhit the pass. Well, reaching a stage in the match, Terry, where one goal can win this.
Yes, one goal. We'll probably see a scrappy goal as well that will win it, because it's been some great quality chances, great quality play, and good goalkeeping on both sides with Scott Howie and Andy Gorham when called upon to produce some terrific saves. And has been end-to-end stuff. It has been a hungry match. Both sides are eager for the points, of course, and no call has been asked, no call has been given. So it's been a very tense and physical battle, but there has been quality there. There has been some good chances. There has been quality passing. So at the end of the day, the punters especially should be pleased with the match.
Dolan's header forward. It's returned there by Goff, and Roddy's in behind him. Wanted too long on the ball. Lambert supporting. So too is Barnes. And Goff goes to the rescue of Ferguson. McLaren completes the clearance only as far as Dolan. Now McKinnon. Came off Dolan last. It's a throw to Rangers. So Dolan, a direct replacement for Billy Davis, right in the centre of that midfield trio. Denham doing well there against Jury, who's guilty of leading into him illegally. It's been a major test for this youngster, Greg Denham, and he's come through it extremely well.
It's easy for David Robertson, but slicing him around. It's
McKinnon knocking in the space for Dolan. Mikhailichenko did well. Here's Derek McInnes. Ferguson puts it to Robertson. This is Petrich. Mikhailichenko limping heavily down below us on the Rangers' right. Pass intended there for Robertson. Andy Roddy back there marking him. They were both at Petrodri together with Aberdeen. Mikhailichenko struggling a bit, saying he's all right, doesn't want to come off. Ennis Ritchie with a clearing, right-footed ball upfield, and now it is Miodrag Ivanovic. Well, just hates to thump the ball forward, although he's got out of his leg with no option but to do just that. Up goes Goff. Charlie Miller get a touch on. That's for Eddie May, now Petrich. Goff has Alan McLaren available. So in the closing 5 minutes, both sides thinking in terms of winning the match right at the end, and Goff stealing forward there. This is Laudrup. Dragging the ball across the face of the box. Great ball to Ferguson. Close again from Rangers. And the creative work done by Brian Laudrup once more.
Good play by Brian Laudrup. Slips the ball inside in. Ferguson on the turn. Quick snapshot. Good strike. Good contact, but about 4 or 5 feet wide. Good effort by Rangers. But good play once again by Mother. They got players in the way. Got players to block him in so that he didn't have a clear passage. But been unable really to make that clear cut chance. Apart from Gordon Dewar, is possibly when he did hit the bar. But all their good players wanted.
Rob McKinnon with a throw. Dolan with McKinnon. Not the angle Dolan was trying to get, I don't think. Jury did well. So then Lambert is offside, Roddy. Toe poke through by Lambert. Roddy slow coming back. Well, really would be a shame, I think, for either side to lose the match at this stage. You have the contribution they both made to the attacking play, the chance making. So the throw goes to Motherwell. Well, the Motherwell defence has been frugal all season, and they've just been looking for a little goal touch up front. Still hasn't materialised tonight. But they've been resilient at the back. Hanging on well. Denham kept it in. Here's Bonds. Tackled there by McLaren. There'll be a hold up here. The Rangers player requires attention. Time now for Terry Butcher to name his man of the match.
Yes, I've gone for a player who's the left-footed good defender, Craig Denham. Greg Denham, I should say, in my opinion, has been the best player for me on the park tonight. Just impressed me because he's been very assured, very confident, hasn't played many games in the Premier League. He's playing against quality opposition, lovely left foot on him, very calm, very assured, and that's a quality player for the future. And Alan McLeish obviously could play himself in the side, but I think he'd just take a back seat and just influence this man, and he'd be able to give him all the tips he can, because Alan was a class defender and very comfortable on the ball himself. But he's done very well. Good left foot, good strong left foot, good strong in the air, and a great prospect.
Greg Denham, just 19 years old, named as man of the match by Terry Butcher. You should know about left-sided central defenders. McKinnon, Plymouth skimming. Was he in Ferguson? There's Dolan now, launching that up beside us in the Coventry country.
He probably heard he wasn't man of the match and tried to hit me with the ball there, John.
But Petric, Lowdrop has gone roaming again, superbly tackled by Ritchie. Well, there's been no question in the Motherwell commitment tonight. They really have battled extremely hard. Could be the kind of performance to set them back in the rails again for the league campaign. There's Gordon Jury. Kalichenko takes over, loves to come inside like this. Here's Richard Goff encroaching forward to join the attack. Loudrop inside the box. Danger here for Motherwell. He retains it after the stumble. McInnes, Lowder again, testing his stamina here. Lambert wins it. Eddie May gets a call inside from Innes Ritchie. There's one for Barnes to chase. One against two, no real prospect of winning that. Now is Richard Goff. Closing minute of the match. Forward it goes from McLaren's hopeful pass. And bouncing away there for the Motherwell throw. Well, we're into stoppage time now. There's been a little bit of that in this second half. Linesman Jim Herald has just signalled to the referee that the 90 minutes are over. So the question of injury time down to the referee. Big skimming, forcing that upfield. Roddy's with Robertson. And there's Petric. Complete miscue by Ritchie, but falling kindly to the feet of Eddie May. That's a bad clearance. So was the ball for McInnes though, and Ritchie pumps the ball deep inside the Rangers' half. These tense, nervous closing minutes when one false move could mean the loss of the match. Another substitution, and Motherwell bringing on Roy Essendon. Player coming off is Andy Roddy. Well, I think this suggests that Motherwell will settle for a point at this stage, Terry.
Well, they'll settle for the point, but Alan McLeish knows that just one long ball, one half chance, and everything else. He's got Essendon very quick up front, and you know, he might get on the end of something. And they've been very tight at the back. I think you know, in the closing stages, they've really shown that they have a great support and a great belief in their manager and each other by battling hard together. And if you've got that belief, and if you've got the skill on the side, you're going to climb the table. I'm sure Motherwell will do that.
So Roy Essendon, 19 years old, his third appearance for the first team as substitute. Gentleman born in Belfast. Goff well forward. There's Jury, and he was matched all the way there. Some very good defending, but an injury there to Krivokapic in the process there of stopping Gordon Jury. And he's in trouble, clearly in trouble. That's serious, that left knee.
Well, Kivokovic had a long spell out through injury, came back in October after months out of the side. Well, the message is clear on Kivokovic, he's in trouble, signalling that to the bench.
He's not too bad. It's a ball dropping here. It's a bit of a block there, as you can see. Gordon Jury just comes through as he makes this shot. It's one of them balls that just drops down. He had to go for it as a defender. He got there at the same time as Gordon Jury. Both a block and ended up. But I think Gordon Jury just catching Kivokovic on the knee with his studs. But it's one of them challenges that a defender has to make in the last minute of the game, and was a very brave one. He's okay.
Well, looks like a bang in the knee, and that's good news for Motherland, for Kivokovic. He couldn't really afford another serious injury at this stage in his career. 36 years old he is now. Still organising at the back as Robertson sends in the long throw. It was well won by Ritchie. Here's Mikhailichenko. Robertson caught there clearly by Barnes. That was a foul. No point in Barnes arguing about it. He certainly caught David Robertson. So a free kick here, the Rangers trying very hard to win the match, as they've done so frequently in the closing seconds. It's a good ball in, needs a touch. Dolan still trying to play passes from defence. Lambert sends it along. Barnes chasing. Referee McCluskey's checked his watch again as Robertson sends it back. Still referee McCluskey in the middle, signals the end of a dramatic match. A handshake there, Walter Smith and Alec McLeish, Archie Knox also, and Motherwell battled manfully to the end there, hanging on a bit at the end. Alec Burns caused so many problems for Rangers in the second half from that right-hand side, and Greg Denham, a tower of strength, the young man, at the back beside Martin and Kivokovic. So Richard Goff trying very hard to inspire a late winner for Rangers, pushing forward. Exchanging pleasantries there with Mio Drag. Kivokovic appears to have recovered completely. And a handshake there from Andy Goran for Kivokovic, also a mark of respect. These Motherwell supporters leaving, and I think Terry entitled to believe that the team may well be back in the rails.
Well, I think there's nothing wrong really with Motherwell, that a goal or two wouldn't help, because at the end of the day, because they've created chances, played very well for the manager and everything else. It's just the case that they haven't scored goals. They haven't scored goals on a regular basis. That's why they're at the bottom of the league. If you don't score goals, you don't win games.
So now down in the tunnel area, Davey Provan is with Rob McKinnon and Greg Denham. Greg, congratulations. You're Terry Butcher's man of the match tonight. But even after all that effort, it's hardly a result that does much for either side. Do you feel Motherwell deserve more out of the game tonight?
I think a point was just a bit justified. Two teams came very close twice. I think a point is a fair result in the end.
It's only your sixth first-team appearance for Motherwell this season. How difficult has it been to make the step up from reserve football to playing against the likes of Brian Loudrop here tonight?
Well, there's a big gulf between reserve football and that out there tonight. But the boys have been magnificent to me, and they've helped me along great.
Rob, what do you make of the contribution that this young man and the likes of Innes Ritchie are making?
Big man's done brilliant in the last few games, and he's steadied us up at the back a wee bit. Been brilliant.
Two away matches coming up now against Hearts and Falkirk. After tonight's performance, do you feel you can approach them with some confidence?
I think we've got to take a wee lift for that tonight. Obviously, we didn't win the game, but the next best thing, we never conceded anything, which is good.
You might be getting a little bit fed up with moral victories. Are you at a stage now where you'd settle for a bad performance, providing you took the points?
I think that'd be nice. It'd be nice over the Christmas period to pick up a few points, definitely.
Well, Greg, you're the man of the match. Rob, perhaps you might present the champagne to him. Well done tonight, lads.
Well done.
Cheers, man.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Just in time for Christmas. That's nice, isn't it? Probably stay in the boxes as well until Christmas Eve. 0-0 then at Fir Park, and we'll get Charlie's thoughts on that when we come back.
International terrorism.
No one's safe.
The government's in on it, but they're still in the line of fire.
I can get to you wherever and whenever I want.
You're a dead man.
One man has a public duty to solve the riddle.
So what the hell is it?
And a personal vendetta to fulfill.
You touch my wife again, I'll separate you from the rest of your life.
Featuring man of the moment, Pierce Brosnan and Ben Cross in the explosive action movie Livewire, tonight at 10 on the Movie Channel.
A few weeks ago, we got Playboy TV.
And since then, all she's done is moan.
I like a good moan.
He who gives an Acuras this Christmas deserves everything he gets.
A Disney video is one gift that'll be enjoyed long after Christmas. With so much joy, magic and excitement, no wonder a child will choose to watch a Disney video time and time again. Disney videos, one Christmas present they'll want to open again and again.
Fast-acting peppermint and spearmint flavour, Rennie.
Now a mintier taste and smoother texture.
12 cans of Stella, only £9.99.
Oh, it's end-to-end stuffies!
Fresher drink stores, magic!
Christmas hair health advice.
You know how this time of year can really take it out of you? Imagine what it's doing to your hair. All that extra blow-drying, combing and brushing, it can leave your hair dull and unhealthy looking. That's why during the party season, it's even more important to use Pantene Pro-V.
Its pro-vitamin B5 nourishes the root and penetrates to the very tips,
leaving my hair looking shiny and radiant with health right through to the new year.
Pantene Pro-V, seasonal treatment for healthy-looking hair.
After eating, dentists agree plaque acid weakens tooth enamel, but chewing Orbital Wrigley's Extra stimulates saliva, which fights plaque acid and helps strengthen teeth against decay.
But the block knows I'm completely stuffed without Hall's Menthol Eucalyptus. As well as soothing eucalyptus, they've got a fantastic menthol vapor action. Just allow one to dissolve slowly in your mouth. And it'll breeze through your nose block in no time. They're available in four flavours, all with fantastic vapour action. Watch out for the extra strong ones.
He who doesn't give an Acuras this Christmas deserves everything he gets.
Subscribe to Playboy TV. Call now. In a world that's full of surprises, you never know what's around the next corner. Central Park West, coming soon on Sky One.
No goals. So Celtic are 2 points adrift. That's all going into Christmas and the new year. That's nothing. 19 attempts, Rangers, hit the target six times. Motherwell, 9 attempts, on target twice. McSkimming booked in the first half. Nobody else's name went in the book. Rangers slightly the better of the action areas first half, but Motherwell had more possession. That evened itself out in the second half. The ball in play, not an hour from the 95 that we had in all. Well, you thought Rangers, Charlie. You were wrong.
I was.
Why?
Well, I think the finishing was quite poor at times tonight, Rangers. I thought Motherwell in the second half played ever so well. Little Alex Burns was busy disturbing the defence of Rangers, but the finishing was fairly poor. They had some good opportunities to score goals. So did Motherwell, in fairness, but I think Rangers had the best of the,
the chances and didn't take them.
Hit the target more often in the second half, but still, as you say, not clinically. Gordon Jury perhaps with the best, with a header that hit the bar just after half-time. Now, if this goes in, it's a totally different game, isn't it?
Well, of course it is. It's a great ball from Mikhailichenko, great vision. And Charlie Muller just knocks it back into the danger area. Jury does well. He attacks it well, gets above the defenders, and he's hit the target with it, and he's a bit unlucky, to be honest. The keeper's caught in no man's land, really. But that was probably the best chance. But it was a difficult header.
Although he was on target again shortly afterwards, Scott Howie was needed to make another very good save.
Yeah, well, we mentioned Scott Howie at the start of the game, how important it could be tonight, and he certainly proved his worth tonight. That's a tremendous save. Again, it's Mikhailichenko and Goff up there again. This is an absolute tremendous strike from Laudrup. But it really didn't look as if, although there was good chances, as if anybody really was going to get a goal, unless it would maybe be a lucky break. But that was a good opportunity again.
The longer it went at 0-0, the more Motherwell must have thought, well, actually, we fancy this now.
Well, they certainly did. Towards the end, I think they were busy enough. They really didn't get forward in great numbers. But in saying that, little Alex Burns, I thought, was quite a thorn in the second half. Looked dangerous whenever he got running at Goff and Petric in particular. It really gave him serious problems.
Got away once or twice, and here's an example of that, when he ended up hitting the post and was very unlucky. It was a good run, wasn't it? But how did he get
it? It was a great run. You see, Petric has been pulled out of the hole. He's straight in it, but this is clever. This is good ability. He's drawn it back inside and completely wrong-footed Richard Goff. And he is a bit unfortunate, but you see at this angle, he's actually, I think he's going in hoping he's going to hit the target. You see, it actually hits McLaren's leg onto the post. If it doesn't hit McLaren, it's really going wider across the goal. He looks as if he's playing well, but he's just lacking in confidence.
OK, let's go back to Fir Park and hear from Alex McLeish. He's with Davy Provan.
Alec, do you feel that you could have asked for any more from your players out there tonight?
No, I don't think so, Davy. They gave their all, and the end result is we've got some more in the wounded list. But it was a great performance, a gutsy performance from them, and it wasn't the worst result in the world.
Well, you've matched the champions and the league leaders. What do you think that will do for your dressing room psychologically now?
Well, I think it'll give them a big lift. You know, obviously Rangers coming here, it does mean a lot to the players to win the game, or, you know, as we did tonight, we got a point and probably won us even just about right at the end. But that'll give them a big lift. You know, certainly they're a bit bubblier than of late, shall we say.
You've had no choice but to throw youngsters like Innes Ritchie and Greg Denham into the fray recently. What did you make of their contribution?
Yeah, well, Innes came on when Brian Martin was beginning to struggle with his hamstring, and he did what he was asked of when he came on the second half of the match. Richard Goff at set pieces, who looked very dangerous early on, and I thought Greg Denham was immense.
Two away matches now against Falkirk and Hearts coming up. Can you approach them now with some confidence?
Yeah, we've all, I said to you before the game, David, there was frustration. The heads weren't down, it was just frustration really, and we're a bit disappointed about the position that we're in at the moment, and I think that performance belies our position.
Thanks a lot, Alec.
Pleasure, thanks.
OK, and we'll get back and get some reaction from Walter Smith, hopefully, but he has to be disappointed tonight, surely.
Alex?
Walter Smith.
I think Walter will be the most disappointed of the two. Alec was looking for, as he says quite rightly, a gutsy performance. He got that from his team. There's a lot of passion. They played fairly well at times, as I say, without getting great numbers forward. But I think he'll be fairly pleased. He's took a point off the league leaders, which is not a bad result for him.
Taken two big points off Rangers, really. Let's have a look at the Premier Division table tonight. Motherwell, well, really needed the win, but the point, psychologically, has to be massive. They're off the bottom. That makes good reading in itself, doesn't it?
It makes very good reading. Plus, they're going to Falkirk away from home soon, so that becomes a real serious game for them. But I think, all in all, they look as if they're playing very well. I think it really probably is frustration that's shown in the camp at the moment rather than lack of a confidence. But I think once they get a victory, I think you can see them quite keen to get back in the habit and climbing the table.
Everyone's played 18 now. Motherwell off the bottom, ninth place above Falkirk. Look at the top, though. Really tight now. 2 points Rangers lead from Celtic as we go into Christmas and the new year. January the 3rd, remember. Parkhead, Celtic versus Rangers, and it's live here on Sky Sports. This is what's coming up on Boxing Day. Falkirk, Aberdeen, Hearts, Motherwell, Partick against Hibs,